Hello friends, let's take a problem where we can use Thevenin's theorem to solve a problem. So let's have a problem. I'm having a voltage source of 100 volt and resistances are of 20, 80, this is 40 and 50, and here it's a load resistance RL. This load resistance can have three values: 5 ohm, 10 ohm and 20 ohm. So in all the three cases, I need to find out what will be the load current using Thevenin's theorem. Let's follow the procedure that we have discussed. First, calculation of VTH. In order to get a VTH, we need to remove RL. So circuit will be like this. Once we have removed RL, we will get two terminals. We will mark that as A and B. Our job is to get voltage across A and B. So I will consider A positive with respect to B. This voltage we will denote as VTH. In order to get VTH, we need to trace a path. So either you can select this path or this path. As we have discussed, we need to select a simplest path. So let's select this path, or you can go for this path also. Let's select this path where I am having 20 and 40 ohm resistances connected, right? So my job is to get voltage across 20 ohm and voltage across 40 ohm. If I know the resistances, I can get voltages provided current should be known. So in this, my objective is get these two currents. Now it's again a very simple circuit where 100 volt is connected between these two points and these two points, where I can directly say current flowing through 20 ohm resistance will be this, and given by 100 divided by 20 plus 80, which is 1 ampere. Same way, current flowing through 40 ohm resistance will be 100 divided by 40 plus 50. If I solve, I will get 1.1111 ampere. So I got the parameters. Now let's select this path. This is point A and B. We consider A positive with respect to B, and the voltage across them is VTH. This is 20 ohm, 40 ohm, current flowing through this is I20, and current flowing through this is I40. Since we have assumed a current direction, same as the current direction, we will get voltage drops. So apply KVL to this loop. I can start from point B and will come to the same point. So from B to A, I am having minus plus, and the voltage is VTH. Minus plus, so it's once more plus 20 multiplied by I20. Plus minus, minus 40 multiplied by I40 equal to 0. So VTH will be 40 multiplied by I40. I40 we calculated as 1.1111 ampere, minus 20. I20 we got as 1 equal to 0. If I solve this, I will get VTH as 24.4444 volt. Again a positive answer I am getting, so assumption is once again correct. So A positive with respect to B. Step number 1 is over. Let's go to the second step. Calculation of RTH. For this, we need to remove RL, and whatever sources are present, we need to replace with their internal resistances. So here we are having only one voltage source. So that voltage source is 100 volt. So 100 volt is short circuit because it is a voltage source. Internal resistance is 0. So if I do the modification here, I will get a circuit like this. I am short circuiting 100 volt. This is 20, 80, 40 and 50 ohm. Let's not forget to mark these points A and B. And here we have to find out RTH across A and B. Again same concept, let's have this point as C. So this entire thing is C only. So let's redraw the circuit. I will get from A to C, there is a 20 ohm. Again from A to C, I have 80 ohm. From C to B, there is 40 ohm resistance. And from C to B, there is 50 ohm. So it's very simple now, because this 20 and 80 are in parallel. The equivalent is 20 multiplied by 80 divided by 20 plus 80. Resultant I will get as 16 ohm. 40 and 50 are in parallel. Resultant is 40 multiplied by 50 divided by 40 plus 50. Here it is 22.2222 ohm. And now these two resistances will come in series. 16 come in series with 22.2222 ohm. So RAB, nothing but RTH, will be 16 plus 22.2222. So finally RTH I will get as 38.2222 ohm. Step number 2 is over. Let's go to step number 3, which is Thevenin's equivalent circuit. It will have VTH in series with RTH. So VTH is 24.4444 volt, and RTH we are getting 38.2222 ohm. Now here A positive with respect to B, so I consider this point is A, this point is B. And the last step, calculation of IL. In our case, we have considered three values of RL. So let's connect the RL to this circuit. Now first case, if RL is 5 ohm, the current flowing through RL, which we denoted as IL, will be VTH divided by RTH plus RL. So if I substitute RL 5 ohm, VTH and RTH value, I will get IL as 0.5656 ampere. Let's decide the direction. How we are going to decide the direction? Let's consider the circuit. So in original circuit, RL is connected like this, and if I remove that, I will get terminals A and B, right? So in our answer, I am getting a current flowing from A to B. So here also it is A to B, but for this horizontal orientation of the load resistance, the current direction is like this, which is from A to B. So this will be the value of IL if I consider RL 5 ohm. Second, if RL is 10 ohm, simply we have to replace RL as 10 ohm, considering VTH, RTH same. So if we solve, we will get IL as 0.5069 ampere, current direction is same. And in third case, RL equal to 20 ohm, if I replace RL as 20, I will get IL 0.4198 ampere, direction is A to B, which is same as the previous two cases. So this will be end of another problem where we use Thevenin's theorem. In subsequent videos, we will solve more numericals based on this. Thank you.